So Derek, you know, harvest is pretty much upon us, and it's probably time for growers to start thinking about their fertilizer budget a little bit and what they want to do. I'm just going to talk to you today a little bit about phosphorus. I know you've done a lot of work with our Verberate programs and writing our prescriptions and stuff like that. Are growers willing to spend money on phosphorus these days?
Oh yeah, without a doubt, Tim. I mean, your three main nutrients are NPK, right? It's right there. It's a huge component of our production. So it's what you're going to put in. We want to be as smart about it as we can, as efficient as we can, and get the return for it.
So I'm Tim Mundorf, Nutrient Management Lead for Central Valley Ag, and today I'm talking to Derek Coma, our ACS Region Manager here around that York area. So Derek, you've been working in Precision Ag for quite a few years, and we all know phosphorus is fairly important. What kind of variation do you see out there in an average grower's field?
Oh man, it really depends, Tim. I mean, you can see anywheres from single digits parts per million levels to, you know, over 100 parts per million level. And it depends on where you're sampling, what you have out there. It also depends on, you know, the lab and the tests that you're running. Yeah. You know, yeah. We really got to take that into consideration on a, you know, are we running a Bray, a Malek, an Olson, right?
Yeah. So when I talk to a grower about his fertility plan, I like to have a good conversation with kind of that systems approach. You know, what's your crop this year? How did you yield? What's your crop plan for next year? What other questions are you guys asking as you're working with that grower as a precision ag specialist?
You know, a lot of times one thing that can easily be overlooked, and it's maybe part of that easy button, you know, let's put a flat rate out there, right? Let's just go with a set flat across the field, one and done. But you know, that variability's out there. It's always out there. Every field, I mean, you watch your monitor when you're harvesting, you're always seeing different colors. If we're not seeing different colors, we don't have a legend set right, because it's out there, right? And 10, 30, 50, you know, 80, 100 bushel swings on corn, right? So, you know, the variability's out there. If we have a crop that's gonna be producing that big of a swing out there, we need to address that. Do we need to get those lower producing areas built up so it's doing the same? Or is that just a spot that we're throwing money and resources away?
Yep. You know? I agree. I always like to talk to a guy about crop removal. When I think about crop removal of phosphorus, like in corn, I always kind of range that conversation around, you know, 200 pounds of MESZ. That is probably a pretty good match for crop removal on about, 200, 250 bushel corn. And sometimes that surprises guys. They don't think that it would take that much fertilizer just to replace what's going out in the truck. Are you used to having that conversation as well?
Oh yeah, yep, exactly right. It's better and better yields every year, all the time now. What we're pulling out of the soil for resources compared to what we were doing 10, 20, 30 years ago is completely different. I mean, you look back and we used to average half the yield that we're getting now. So, you know, you think about that, that's twice the removal. Yeah. We got to get it back somehow, right? Yeah. You know, every crop we put out there, it's utilizing nutrients, you know. Each crop's going to be a little bit different. It's going to be pulling a little bit different for certain nutrients, but it's always pulling from that soil. And we're just mining those resources if we're not managing that and putting it back. And, you know, even some guys will say, well, but for so many years, I've been getting a great yield off of this, and I haven't been doing anything, or I haven't been doing much. But at what point does that turn around?
Yeah.
And the really bad part about that is if we get to that point, now we're so far down that the cost input we're looking at to build that back up, and the time we're looking at, and the limitation on yield potential until we get back there, you know, that's not things that happen overnight, and that's not things that we can afford to do overnight.
I agree completely. When you think about that systems approach again, every crop needs nutrients, so let's get a little out there every year. If you want to be a little heavier some years, maybe that's a better year for you as far as your financials go. Maybe it's a little bit better bargain on the price of phosphorus that year. That's fine, go heavy that year. But I don't really like years with no applications. We go to try to chase yield, a little fresh fertility out there every year in the form of commercial fertilizer makes a lot of sense to me.
Yep, it really does, Tim.
So Derek, thanks for joining us today on Agronomy Focus. So with Derek Coma, the ACS Regional Manager here in the York area, I'm Tim Mundorf, and this has been your Agronomy Focus video.